Hello everyone, and welcome to another traditional draft of Forgotten Realms. And this is another pack that is very strong. There are multiple first pick quality cards. Olber, always worth first picking. It is the best common in the pack, so that would be the choice out of the commons. The rare is pretty good, but it's not like insane. You can get a 2-for-1, well actually it is like a 1-for-0 more like, so opponent is trying to remove your creature with a removal spell and then you can just save it and you get this 3-mana 3-2 vigilance creature too. And then the Bruenner is first pickable, it is very good card actually, the stats alone are great. Lightfoot, Rogue and the Cleric class are also, well maybe the Cleric class is not that great, but yeah, the point is, a lot of these cards are good, and I'm not sure. I kind of want to go for the Bruenner, but it is two colors. It is pretty awkward, but I take it still. It feels like it is so strong compared even to the other ones. And yeah, I think this is better than the rare. The rare is not always going to be that useful, and sometimes it's just a 3-mana 3-2, even though it has flash, so it's not always great. Red Dragon is easy pick here. When I took a red-white card, of course I want to pick red and white cards as a continuation. So someone took an uncommon over the Red Dragon. Of course the Treasure Vault is bad, so that's not a pick. So someone found a better uncommon. I wonder what it is, but doesn't matter. I'll take this and I'm happy about the first two picks I have had here. Now there is a green dragon, which is also good, not as good as the red or white dragon, but it is the third dragon that costs only 6 there. Well, black and blue ones, they cost 7, so they are kinda not so desirable because of the expensive mana cost. But given what I have here, the pick has to be the Hobgoblin Captain. I might have some equipment synergy, and this is a very decent 2-drop. So I'm gonna keep the colors here. Picking the green dragon could be okay, but it's not as good as the red. So I think I'll just try to pick the good red 2-drop here and see if I can go red-white. And if not, well then I switch the colors. Now, how about the smith in here? With Bruenner, I do want to have some equipment, and of course, in red-white in general, I want to have some equipment. But I think this has a chance to come back to me, maybe at pick number 12. That is quite late also, although, but there's another Hobgoblin Captain, which I might want to have over the Dwarfhold Champion here. Getting the first strike for this thing is pretty decent, so let's take it. Also, this means that if fight suddenly isn't going to be open, I can still just focus on red here. Monk of the Open Hand. I think I'll just take the Armory Veteran over it. I could take the Ranger's Hawk too. But if I'm finding some equipment here, the Armory Veteran will be pretty decent. Okay, let's take it. Okay, there's a equipment, but it's not a good one. There's a Knoll Hunter though. I definitely want for this deck to have more like an aggressive deck equipment. Well, I'm not gonna play the green cards. I don't like the Paladin Shield, so I guess this is a thing. But it's more likely that I'm gonna be red-green. So let's take the green 2-drop and see how it goes. Okay, Dueling Rapier. I think I'll take it over the Spoils of the Hunt. I still want to be red-white because I have the very good Bruenner here. Well, there's a Bull Strength. I don't know. I guess the shield isn't the worst with the Hobgoblins. Fine, let's take it now. I don't necessarily want to take the green cards unless I get something very good. The Knoll Hunter alone is not enough to pull me the green. So okay, now Armory Veteran. Well, there's a Ranger's Longbow. Potion of Healing, +1 plummet. This is best of three draft, so I suppose if I go green, I don't like the Direwolf Prowler at all, but if I go green, the plummet will be useful. Yeah, I passed a lot of white cards, but they just were not that good. I need, of course, some very good white cards. Okay. This Brunner is... I think it might be splashable, but it depends on how many cards I can find. I'll take the blue card. I don't need two of those longbows. I mean, there's not that many ways to splash in this format. Treasures are one way, of course. And red can have some treasure generation. Now here, the only red card is the unexpected windfall. Not going to pick that here. And red white isn't really a life gain deck, because red obviously doesn't have a life gain, doesn't suit its color pie abilities. I'm not taking the green cards either. The rare is not for these colors. It's going to be, I mean, I guess the Lightfoot Rogue is good too, but I'm just figuring out if I should take something like a Planar Ally here. I mean, I could take the Rally Maneuver, but I'd rather have my non-creature speed removal and equipment and not pump effects. So let's take the Planar Ally here. Okay, Meteor Swarm. talk about a crazy good card. At 4 mana, it's basically a sorcery speed, destroy target creature. At 5 mana, you usually can kill two, and sometimes at 6 mana, if you have the mana for that, you can kill even three creatures. So it's absolutely fantastic removal spell. How many Armory Veterans I'm going to play? Well, I'm not going to play the Barbarian class. I don't have die rolling. This is just 20 gems. Now the Devoted Paladin is a card you can play. I have here a bunch of 2-drops. Maybe I'll take the Devoted Paladin here this time. Although it is a second 5-drop already. Now here I would of course want to have the Hulking Bugbear, but you are not going to pass the Dragon's Fire. Not even over a hasty 3-3 for 3. Okay, Gnoll Hunter, bye-bye. It's going to be red-white. And here... there is the Minimus Containment, which I don't like that much. But I think one of those is always reasonable. So let's take... It's just you better not play it very early, because then the opponent can get some good value out of the treasure. But this does answer anything. Okay, I think the +2 mace is the pick here. Okay, Grim Bounty, pick 6, wow. Anyway, especially with Brunner, it's going to be very decent. And even without it, it's not a bad equipment. It's not the greatest either. How am I going to get a pick 7 Dragon's Fire? Well, I'm super happy I got it, but wow. With 2 equipments? No, 3 now. Maybe I'll take another Armory Veteran. I don't have a lot of treasures. I guess this is decent with the burn spells, because I can, you know, deal first strike damage to like 5 toughness creature, then kill it with the Dragon's Fire. But with the 3 equipment, I'll play the Armory Veteran number 3 there. Not playing the Gloomstalker, this is not a Venture deck. I think I'm gonna play the Boots of Speed here, yep. I take the Ranger's Hawk, but that might get cut here. Not sure yet. But yeah, I think I have enough equipment now. Let's get just, well, I guess 4th Armory Veteran. I'm not sure how many of these guys I want to play, but... well, we'll see. I can definitely cut at least one of them. I have played the red-white deck quite a few times. Not with great success, I don't think, but... I mean, these were the opening colors, definitely the red was, and with Brunner I was very much of incentivized to also have red, a white to pair with the red. Guess Bear Dagger, Sellsword, Do I take the sellsword? Oh, the dagger is fine sideboard card, but I think I'll need creatures in this deck for now. Plus, it is the good part about it is that I have two, Dragon's Fires, which means that with the sellsword and also, of course, with the red dragon too, they can deal 4 damage, which can definitely be relevant. Okay, this is not a Cloister Gargoyle deck. Tiger Tribe Hunter, Priest of Ancient Lore. You hear something on what's holding Ogre. I would want to have the Tiger Tribe Hunter, but I have two kind of reasonable 5 drops and I have no 3 mana creatures. I think I should just take the Priest here to be able to curve out nicely. How about here? I think it's gonna be the Dawnbringer Cleric because this is a best of 3 event. This means I can have enchantment removal in the sideboard. Yeah, I think that is the pick here for the sideboard. I'm not that excited about playing the other cards, plus some of them probably will wheel to me. Okay, now this is a pack of reasonable cards, but nothing too amazing. The Ingenious Smith looks at top 4. How many artifacts I have here? Well, it's a total of 4, all the 4 equipment. I don't know really. I feel like I need creatures, but am I going to take another 4-drop creature here? The Dungeoneer or Sellsword? I think I could take the Dungeoneer. If I play the Planar Ally, I might have some. And if I play the Ranger's Hawk, I might have some amount of venture. So let's take the 3-4. It's also better with the equipment because toughness might be a bit more valuable in that case. Divine Smite definitely the pick here because, yeah, against Black. It's a fantastic sideboard card. maybe the Flyer. I wanted to have 3 drops, but I just never got them. Oh, another Sellsword. Now with double Dragon's Fire, it can be okay, but just a 4-mana 4-3 in the end. I like the Flyer a bit more. Okay, so Dwarf Hall Champion is pretty decent with all the equipment I have, so maybe I should just take it over like another Dungeoneer. I guess at this point I need to start cutting when I put cards into the deck. I'll still take the 2-drop here. Another plus 2 mace, but don't like to. I mean, I guess the 4 equipment I have, that's enough. But I have the Paladin Shield, which I'm not too excited about, but I think it's still okay. I'll take the U here, something on watch, and I will put it to the sideboard against the other aggressive decks. And here, yeah, the equip cost of 5 is so miserable. And this doesn't auto snap, so you have to pay actually 6 mana before you get anything out of this. Now, am I gonna take the Smith? Maybe, let's put to the deck, but I don't think I'm gonna play it. Okay, I got this thing back. Am I gonna play it over the Planar Ally? It is a Trampler. Do I want to have 2 of these in the sideboard? I'll take the Uncommon. Maybe I'll play it over something else. Oh, Null Hunter here, it's so late. I don't think the Javeliner is that great. I have enough 2 drops here, which I'm gonna play over it. I'll take the Null Hunter away because it's not supposed to be there, I don't think. Maybe I want to have another access to another rapier. I don't think the Swarming Goblins is the kind of 5 drop I need here. Okay, now I got the spare dagger for the sideboard. And am I gonna play double Boots of Speed? It's unlikely. I'll just take the Uncommon. I don't think I'm gonna sideboard into another one of those. That could be a sideboard card I wanna have. Okay, so this sideboard doesn't have cards I want to main deck. Some of these I already have in the main deck. Well, I suppose mostly the Dueling Rapier. So let's see how the deck looks like. Amount of creatures is currently 18, so I can cut some of them. Yeah, I think the... Well, the Ranger's Hawk of course does carry equipment, but it's still just a 1-1. That's 25. Now, I'm not gonna play 17 lands. I'm gonna play 17 because I have the triple red card here. Paladin's Shield. Maybe I'll have it as a trick. Yeah, the Ingenious Smith, I think, yeah. It can only find one of the four artifacts. Looking at the top four, yeah, I don't have a treasure generation. If I had ways to generate treasures, this would be better because then it, you know, can grow. But I don't think I have. So I will cut that one. And then probably will cut one more card. Now that is not a lot of venture. Yeah, that's definitely not a lot. But do I want to cut any 4-drop here? A 5-drop perhaps? I have 3 5-drops. This is more like a, you know, 5 or 6-drop. Well, at minimum it is a 4-drop, but with triple red requirement, it's not that easy to play it as a 4-drop. So, I guess I can make treasures with this thing, but no, I'm not gonna play that. I'm just thinking about also if I should play the Dueling Rapier another Dueling Rapier instead of the Paladin's Shield. Maybe not. But I think I will cut a card. One of the veterans. I have 1, 2, 3. That's 7 mana creatures. Guess it could be the Dungeoneer too. It could be the Planar Ally. I mean, I don't... But it being a flyer... Yeah, and it gets me some... Yeah, I guess I'll cut the Dungeoneer. Maybe that's the least useful card. When I don't really have a lot of venture going on. This can at least get multiple ventures. And it is, you know, a flyer... which can be useful. Yeah, so this is the deck. 15 creatures. I have at least plenty of 2-drops, even though I don't have more than 1 3 mana creature here. So yeah, I will be able to sideboard into something else, but this is what I'm gonna start with. And mana without any evolving wilds or stuff like that can be a bit awkward, but I have to play 10. Want to play 10 mountains, but I don't want to play only 7 plains, so I will play 9-8 here and hope that when I'm, you know, I can find the third mountain at some reasonable amount of time for the meteor swarm. Okay, that's it. Well, with the priest, I have one extra card here, so not a great hand, you know, 5 lands here, but it's a keepable one. Oh, come on. And that's the first card drawn. Okay, and the hold. Oh, come on, but... Please. They get the free treasure also. Annoying, but what can I do? I suppose I got the free card out of this. Yeah, they just draw two cards right away. Meteor Swarm. Well, that's gonna be great. Now, I think what I'm doing here is just... I can offer the trade with the priest. I mean, I would love to attack for... for five here, but... don't want to give them a free another token of treasure here. So I'm... I'll attack with this and re-equip on the priest and then, you know, offer it as a blocker on that thing. And then maybe the meter swarm can give me some great value. Feign death. Okay, well, I guess I'm gonna just take 2-for-1 here. It's gonna be a 7 total toughness here, so let's just get rid of those things. Well, they still have a bunch of cards here. Oh, come on. Now, well, I did keep 5 lands. So I have drawn in 6 cards, 3 lands, and 3 non-lands. Anyways, this is pretty okay because... no, it's actually not. In order to attack with this thing, I need to make this guy haste. And then this won't have menace. So I actually have to, because I'm not gonna offer the trade with that thing, I'm gonna do it like this and like this. Next turn this will have first strike. I don't have to haste it up then anymore. Well, that's a lot of treasures, but yep, they are gonna draw a bunch of cards and I mean they're just gonna outvalue me here, especially when I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spells and 8 lands. Okay, okay. I wonder why they chose that. Come on, Dick. I mean, the opponent can't raise me now when I draw only lands here. So I kept the 5 lander, but it had the card draw effect. Yeah. I mean, you can all have all your dragons there. Look at this. I mean, let's count. That's 10 lands total. So I drew... well, in general, it was 10 lands and 5 non-lands. But in my starting hand, I drew 8 cards. 5 of them were lands. 3 of them were non-lands. So, they have a bunch of dragons there. How do I beat them? Don't think I do. Divine Smite will be fantastic here at least. And, do I need to play this thing? Tapper. The flyer isn't that great against the dragons, but I have ways to enhance it with the equipment. Paladin's Shield might be worse than... let's just take that out, actually. So do I want to play another Rapier? Maybe I do. Spedagger, they don't have one toughness creatures that many there. So I'm gonna cut what exactly? It could be the planar ally that I don't need. Yeah. That's it, I think. I guess the shield can still be okay in, but no, I want to have the extra power perhaps. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, that's a more reasonable starting hand. Well, now that's the 5 mana for the paladin. Let's not draw a ton of lands now. Take a trade here. Now I can go 4 drop into 5 drop now, that is good. Are they having only removal there? Nothing here. Okay, that's scary. They might have their dragons again. Okay, I'm gonna play the Tribe Hunter this turn, and then next turn the Divided Paladin will be a pretty good one. Oh, the opponent. What kind of a hand they kept? Is there a mass removal? No, there's the black rare artifact, I think. But they must play something now. Okay, they played nothing. Yeah, I don't know what they kept there. Anyway, I didn't really learn a lot here. I think I still want to have the rapier. It's pretty decent with these 4-2 minis guys. Yeah. Let's go. Okay, mulligan. Okay, this is good. Now, yeah, the veteran should go. Hobgoblin is slightly better. Don't have the... Okay, that can have... That is okay, but... yeah, I wouldn't have wanted to see the one that makes treasures. This time I'm not offering the trade here. I have the 2-1 here. So I'm gonna let that go through. I'm gonna attack with this guy. Trading with the Valor Singer is okay. That's fine, and then I can block the Hexblade with this guy. And then I have the Bruenor next turn. And the Divided Paladin will be active at some point. Well, let's see if they have a Feign Death this time. It doesn't draw any cards. Okay, that's just trading resources. That's fine. No instant speed removal. Do they have a blocker for it? Well, okay, they raise me instead. I think I'm gonna go for the veterans now and then have the paladin on the following turn. Don't know why they're trading here damage, because I am... Okay, well, definitely I'm happy I left the paladin here, but I'm not happy that my veterans can't... Well, whatever, I mean, I'm doing this, but this is very annoying. So let's say if I attack with all, they eat one of these, they can trade with one of them, and then they take 6. Not worth it. Not worth it. Oh, if they block with the cult elemental, I would be super happy, but They must have another. I mean, that was so good for me. Because now I can attack with the devoted paladin. Unless they have... Okay, well, now I need... For example, that. That's not bad. Yeah, there's no reason to make the trade with this thing, so I'm gonna just make this have menis and attack for 4 or trade with the fang blade here. Let's see the black dragon now. At least I can... Yeah, that is good, but... Oh, come on. I can deal 6, they deal 7. If I didn't have this many lands... Well, I can't stay and block because I will lose the race. I guess I need my Meteor Swarm, just to have my own 2-for-1 here. Yeah. Things were good until they dropped the Black Dragon here. Okay, now they have a 2-turn clock. I was kinda hoping that, because this is 7 damage, I can take this twice, and then... I'm not losing, but now I can't take it twice. I Well, I guess I did everything I could. Oh. Sure. That works. I mean, I'm not winning with any. Yeah, the problem is they can attack with all. I drew the Divine Smite 1 turn too late. Sadly, they are at 9, so... I mean, if they attack only with the dragon, that's great, but if they attack with all, it's game over. Could this have been earlier? Yes, it could have, because the... Well, whatever. Let's have another traditional draft beginning with a loss, because why not? I mean... The game one was just complete flood, so that wasn't even a the game three wasn't a complete flood. That could have been either way, but nasty to lose one game to just flooding out. Okay, more hands like this, please. Now, it's not the best. If I don't draw lands, this can be really troublesome. But it seems like it's impossible to go 3-0 in this format. I mean, it's just impossible for me, I mean, not for others. Well, I'm gonna play this. If they try to block it, I can get value out of the rapier. Hopefully, I just draw a land, though. But let's see what they do. And I did draw the land. That's good. It's a wrong color though. I didn't actually... No, it's exactly... it is the wrong color. But I still take the value here. I can't actually play another spell here, but... That was too good to ignore. I mean, I have a 5-3 here, and I just got to kill this for free. So this could be... Oh, very fantastic. Yep. So they had no 3 mana play. I can just kill that thing. Although, yeah, I don't have to, because this will have first strike. And I have the Pegasus now, so they're gonna take... well, they're gonna take here 9 damage unless they jump block the first striker. That's pretty harsh. I'm not sure they want to kill that one, because I have a flyer here, which is gonna be a bigger problem for them. So I can play only one spell. This won't have first strike. Unless I equip. Now if I equip this to be a 5, yeah, that's actually 5 power first striker. They have to jump block. Because other way is to do it is to just equip the Pegasus, but I think this is better. Now they will have to jump block. Because they even with double block they don't get to. Oh, they just conceded that way. But anyway, double block would have not killed the goblin. So yeah, green, black. Spells of the Hunt, Gnoll Hunters, good cards there. But I had a explosive start here. Divine Smite, yeah, it's gonna exile black stuff. And do I care about the Paladin Shield again? This time the flyer will be probably pretty good. What's the cut? I can always cut one of the veterans. I do like to have this Paladin Shield, perhaps. So this... I can also use this against their Gnoll Hunters. But what I mean, I have only 14 creatures. I don't want to cut. Okay, I guess I could... Okay, let's do this. Let's cut the Paladin Shield after all, and let's play the U here, something on watch. Because they have probably an aggressive deck, so this is good against. It's a 2-mana, 5-point burn. It's pretty good. Yeah, this is not a keep. Opponent did mulligan too. They kept 6. I mean, this hand is so good if I draw multiple lands, but I'm gonna keep it still. And those the maze here. Because I have the dragon. One land in top 2 draw steps is gonna be enough to, you know, play. And I did draw it. Play the Dragon's Fire. Another land gives me the Priest of Ancient Lore, and then if the game goes late, I get to play the Meteor Swamp. So top 2 cards were lands, so now it was time to be very lucky here. I mean, I just kept the one lander. Now they have a pretty decent card after a mulligan too, but I also have my 2-for-1 here. So I'm not unhappy at all. Okay. I think I'm just killing it and having the boot. I don't want to show the rapier to them. I will use it as a trick instead. I use the Dragon's Fire because I have another, and I have a Meteor Swarm here too, which just, of course, does require another red still, but hopefully the game is... Okay, they get this, they get to venture. Yeah, I'm gonna offer the trade now, I suppose. Especially if I draw a land here. They might not even block here, but let's see. And I know I could have played the Brunner and equip it for free, but I'd rather not only let them trade away, and then I have a better chance that that I have the Brunner here. Oh, I did kind of forget this thing. It has also the first ability. Oh man, this card is so good. I completely forgot it gives +2/+0 to equipped creatures. That's insane. And I even drew the mountain. Now, if they don't have removal, they're gonna have a bad time. But let's see what they draw. Oh, and I have to. Wow. This could be a game over. That's 14 damage. Yeah, but that's the reason I first picked this guy. This is insane. And I didn't even remember the +2/+0 here. Now they have a black dragon. That's good. But I have a meteor swarm here. So this is still a victory, right? It is. Because I have exactly the dueling rapier here. Wow. Look at this. So 4 mana, x equals 1 here. So all the guys have black dragons, but this time it didn't matter. Okay, 5 drop, 6 drop with 5 lands. I'm not getting good starting hands here, that's definitely sure. I mean, the red dragon is so good that I'm actually considering this. I would have to draw. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it because this is such a good 5 and 6 turn, but and I have a lot of cheap cards, so I just need to draw some of them. But I can just get overwhelmed here. Yeah, well, I suppose that makes the red dragon turn 6 a possible play. And I did draw a cheap card here, that is good. So now just have some play for turn 4. And then I can, you know, curve out nicely here. Good. That is perfect. Doesn't matter what it is, just something to put to the battlefield. And now I can go for the 5 drop, 6 drop curve. Opponent, you have to do something. That's fine. I won't be attacking into that. They get to scry too. Boot on top. Okay, now I don't need any more lands. I suppose I have a double white card in the deck, so at some point I might need a plains. But let's see how many removal spells the opponent has, or counter spells. Zombie Ogre. That works for now. I don't know why they didn't attack with the 3-3, but I'm happy they didn't. Yeah, I can throw this on something, but it doesn't really work. No, I'm just gonna do this. I hope they don't have a removal, but they have 5 cards in hand. Oh, come on. A planeswalker. So they get to. It has menace and reach. But they did. Okay, I guess that's not the best thing there is. This does. Target creature. Okay, so now I need to kill. I guess they're gonna block with the windshear anyway, but with the rapier and this having trample. I can kill only one of these things, so I could throw the cell sword into this winch here, but it makes no sense. So what I'm doing here is I'm gonna attack, I'm gonna throw the veteran on the one of the two ones, And that means they will probably double block the red dragon with these guys. And then they will block the tribe hunter with the 3-5. And then I can trample over and finish the spider queen here. Yep. Oh, I've kind of forgot that thing. It won't die, but it will have only one loyalty. So I suppose it's fine. And I get to kill the zombie ogre. That's no, you know, that's not pointless at all. That is very good. Now they have one mana up, do they? Oh, they are gonna get more loyalty for this thing, actually. Okay, so the Planeswalker is gonna win the game for them. I mean, big surprise. Planeswalkers are pretty good in limited. At least this one is good. Oh, they have a Feign Death on that thing. How annoying is that? Now, so this goes to one loyalty, but then it will go back to, what, four? Don't think there's a victory here. They get another two. Yeah, whenever they block with these things, they get loyalty back. Oh yes. They chose to use the zero ability. Oh, how many black dragons there are in the game? Well, let's take this. This also works on Planeswalkers. And then I guess I need the Rapier, not the Paladin Shield. And that might be it. Spear Dagger doesn't have one toughness. Yeah, man. I mean, the entire game was decided when they played this thing and had the Black Dragon, of course, too. But even just this thing, I mean, my Red Dragon was just a joke there after that. Let's have another 1-2, shall we? What is the worst card? One of the veterans, maybe? I mean, I don't really want to... Yeah, well, let's lose one of the veterans. Should have played the planes to not show them that I have the rapier here. Do I might just play the rapier now to start attacking for a bunch of damage? I'm kind of hoping they somehow attack. I don't know. Maybe I just lost their damage. Okay, yeah, sure. Okay. That is 7 lands. And 3 non-lands. In 10 draws. And this time I didn't even keep a... I mean, I kept a 4-lander. I drew 3 lands. Into it. They're not gonna block with the Roper, are they? They're gonna get the free dresses, but I mean, yeah, I guess I could have attacked one. If I drew any creature, I would just block this guy. No, it's not gonna happen. They get treasure tokens, and I mean, this is another draft where I lose to floods. And they have the Dragon Queen. Wow.
I will show you what happens when the spiders squash back.
Yeah, well, that happened. Not much you can do about it. Sometimes you can just run very badly multiple drafts in a row. This time it happened again. I didn't even find a mythic rare here, so that's bad for the collection. That's just a waste of gems here. Yeah, one extra pack there. And did I get even a rare here? Yeah, I got the meteor swarm here. All right, well, I mean, there's not much to say about that. It was just a joke of an event. And hopefully, I mean, because the deck I had was good, but obviously there was no beating the opponents. The matches I lost, it was not really much of a. I think, well, I don't remember all the games I lost, but I do recall that there were some non-games in there making things harder. Next one will be a premier draft, so let's see how that goes. See you then. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.